Jessica.
Wonderful. Let's stand and worship.
Thank you so much, praise team, for leading us in a time of worshiping the Lord through song. In just a little bit, we're going to worship Him through the Word, but I just want to welcome you this morning. We're so glad that you're here, and this is the portion of the service where we pray, and we pray specifically for a missionary that's in focus. We also offer an offertory prayer, even though we're not actively passing the plates anymore. It's still a part of our worship service. And it's, my little statement over the years has been, I don't mind, you know, making the house payment. Don't mind buying the groceries. Don't mind when the kids were home buying their little dresses and all those kinds of things. Don't mind at all. But I love writing my check to the Lord for the work here that begins here at Centerview. And just like in the book of Acts, the Lord sent his church out to the ends of the earth so that your offering doesn't stay here. In fact, our missionary focus, some of it stays here, quite frankly. There's, you know, expenses associated with having a facility and having staff. But one of our missionaries in focus today are, we're going to call them Ray and Sarah Cruz. They are actually serving with the International Mission Board of the Southern Baptist Convention. We like to say at Centerview, we're Christians with a big old giant capital C. We're Baptists with a lowercase b. Part of our baptistic identity is that we cooperate together with Southern Baptist missions, and so they're one of our many thousands of missionaries. They're serving Lord Jesus in the continent of Africa. They tell the story of when they first went to mission training, you know, several decades ago. There was a young lady, and again, the Cruz family is not their real name. They're in an Islamic country, and their security, for security reasons, their real identity is kept on the down low. But they had a little girl that was teaching them the language. So, in case you didn't know, when a missionary is called, oftentimes the missionary thinks, well, I'm going to go here, I'm going to go there. And then once you go through the process, they discover, no, you're really going to go here. So they did not know how to speak the language in the African country to which they were going. So they had to first learn the people's heart language. So a little girl named Azia taught them. And here's the thing, and it's often the case. Some of the people who teach language to missionaries are not Christians. And so the Christians will say, can you explain to me John 3:16, you know, in the heart language of the people? So it was an opportunity for them to witness to their language trainers. The long and short of it is, years later, they came back to the training center, and that young lady was now a mom and a vibrant Christian. So the seed that had been planted, you know, God gave fruit to that seed. And so we just thank the Lord for what this couple is doing on the continent of Africa. Africa's not a one-size-fits-all. You know, I had the opportunity in the military on a med float to just go to the northern part of Africa. It is a big continent, and so many people groups. And so we thank the Lord for our Southern Baptist presence on the continent of Africa. And we thank the Lord for Ray. We'll call them Ray and Sarah Crew today. Thank you for your faithfulness to the Lord. We are still ahead of budget. By the way, that enables us to do a lot of things. One of the things I told Scarlett, who gave the announcement about that ladies' conference, is at Centerview Baptist Church, we don't ever deny anyone the opportunity to do something because they don't have a little fee. I never, ever want someone at Centerview Baptist Church to not send their kid to camp, for example, because they don't have the money. So one of the ways that when we're blessed, if there are ladies that want to go but don't have the $40, we're happy to provide you a scholarship here at Centerview. You know, if you can pay, wonderful. But if you can't, don't forsake going to the conference. Just let us know. And at the registration table, just say, Pastor Mike said so, and they will write it down. Okay, you go without cost. And because of your tithes and offerings, we're able to do things like that. Well, today I've got some mixed feelings because, you know, I'm looking out at my brother Dennis Cole, and this is his last Sunday with us for now. Now, he still has some family. You might come back conceivably at some point, Dennis, for a visit, but he has sold his house, and he's got this little thing that, you know, Diane and I have 10 of called grandchildren. And, you know, granddads, you know, want to be where grandbabies are. Oh, the parents are there too, his children. They're not completely unimportant. But he is moving to Texas to be with family, and he has been such an inspiration to me. Dennis is a widower, and I don't want to embarrass him. I can't tell you how many times there's been a family here in need, and Dennis has come and crunched some $100 bills into my hand, or I don't want to embarrass him, but, you know, sometimes even more serious than that and something with a lot of zeros in it, and just said, I want you to take care of this family. He's done that countless times at Christmas. We have Linda's playground, and Linda was his dear wife. And he came here and noticed we had a kind of a decrepit playground. It was small, and Florence kind of took care of it and just smashed it. And now we have a beautiful playground that you know, I know more than $50,000 went into it. Most of it came from the Cole family, just being honest with you. And we named it in honor of his dear wife, who's with the Lord Jesus now. And so, so Dennis, you know, one of the message this morning, Paul's thanking the Lord for the body of Christ at Ephesus. Now, he had been the pastor there, but the church had changed. I'm going to speak to that. Membership is a dynamic thing. It's a dynamic thing for the church at Ephesus. It's a dynamic thing at Centerview. People are coming and going, all in the purposes of God. So Dennis has stood over people many times as we've prayed. And when a family leaves, we stand over them and pray over them, because we are actually commissioning them as missionaries to go out. So he's going to Texas, but he's really a missionary from Centerview. Now, Texas is a wonderful state. We did a tour of duty there. Here's what you have to learn if you go live in Texas. Just tell them, I got here as quick as I could. I'm not a native, but I got here as quick as I could. And they'll let you slide. But we're praying for Texas, Dennis, because I know that there are people everywhere need the Lord, including Texas. So Dennis, do me a favor, brother, if you would come forward. And if you have family with you today, they can come as well. But we're going to pray over Dennis. I'm going to ask our deacons and pastors and chaplains, and if you're an ordained man of God, I just want you to come. And we're going to surround Dennis with our love and prayers. And Dennis, we miss you already. He is the real deal Christian, folks. He is a silent server of the Lord Jesus. He sees a need. He doesn't wait for someone to write a book about it. Dennis is there taking care of it. And I'm so proud of you, friend. And he has a heart for people. I mean, whether you're a single person at this church or a family, if he knows you have a need, Dennis will be looking you up. And I hope I embarrassed you something good this morning. we just want you to know we love you and appreciate you. Let's pray for our brother Dennis. Father, we thank you that you tell us in your word that you put even the solitary into families. But we thank you that the Cole family, Lord, they've been a legend in this town going back to Dennis's dear father, Ed, and his mother. And so, Lord, they've made a huge impact. Ed's made a huge impact in this church, in this community, and working at the sheriff's department after retiring out in California and resettling back at his homeland. So, God, as he makes a new day, as he goes to be with his family, would you open doors of opportunity? Would you thank you that you are the God of all comfort? And even though we don't like this part of doing church at Centerview, but Lord, we thank you that we're still in your family. And one day there's going to be a homecoming where, and there'll be no more goodbyes. We'll all be together with you to ever worship you. In the meantime, God bless his family in Texas, and bless the other family that still live elsewhere in California, I believe, and just watch over them. And we thank you for his sacrifice, for his labor of love. And Lord, we want to pray for that missionary family today. Thank you for positioning them on the continent of Africa. Continue to give fruit to their ministry. Thank you for the faithfulness of your people here to bring their tithes and offerings so that your kingdom work could be done, beginning here and going to the ends of the earth. Lord, we love you. Bless Dennis. Bless his family. We love you. Take charge of this service. Be glorified in their lives. Lord, for the person who's hurting today, who hasn't told a soul, God, would you touch them today? Would you let them know that you are the God who sees their need even before they utter a word? So God, meet the needs of your people today. We'll give you all the praise and glory in advance. Be with our military folks who are not here today, or homebound who are listening online today. Encourage them, comfort them in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Father, we love you and we're going to miss you. Thank the Lord for you. Let's worship the Lord again through song.
Stand and sing.
Shame is